Assalamu alaikum. Today our lecture is a dermatosis of a pregnancy. A pregnant woman can be subjected to a dermatosis during her pregnancy, which is either a specific for a pregnancy and called dermatosis of a pregnancy, or any other diseases that can affect any person. Dermatosis of pregnancy regarded as a heterogeneous group of pruritic disorder that for decades represent a confusing group of overlapping entities. And before we will discuss these dermatoses, we should know the physiologic changes that is occur normally during pregnancy and is not considered as a disease. First of these changes is pigmentary, including hyperpigmentation in the areola, for example, and linea nigra, which is a linear hyperpigmentation in the abdomen. Nearly this hyperpigmentation occur in 90% of a pregnant woman. Melasma occur in 70% of a pregnant woman. Other changes that is occur in hair include hirsutism, postpartum telogen effluvium, postpartum androgenetic alopecia. Changes in the nail include subungual hyperkeratosis, distal onycholysis, transverse grooving, brittleness. Changes that is occur normally in the gland include increased eccrine function, except in the palm, I mean increased sweating, increased sebaceous function, decrease apocrine function. In connective tissue, the most important changes that is occur nearly in all pregnant women is the setariae gravidarum that is occur in up to 90% of patients, and often may resolve or decrease in appearance. Both hormonal factor and physical stretching of the skin appear to be relevant to their development. Vascular changes that is occur normally in a pregnancy is spider angioma, palmar erythema, non-pitting edema, so common especially in late pregnancy, varicosities, vasomotor instability, purpura, gingival hyperemia or hyperplasia, pyogenic granuloma, so common especially after injury, and hemorrhoids. These two pictures represent two of the physiologic changes that is occur in a pregnancy. This represent linea nigra that is occur normally, and this picture represent palmar erythema that occur in pregnant women. Now we will enter the subject of dermatosis of a pregnancy. The first one is pemphigoid gestationis, or what is called herpes gestationis. From its name, pemphigoid gestationis, this disorder is considered as an entity or the same bullous pemphigoid that is occur during a pregnancy. Now, its onset. It is so important to know the onset of every dermatosis. Typically in late pregnancy, such as second or third pregnancy, third trimester, or immediately postpartum. Regarding the clinical picture that present this dermatosis, may present with pruritic, it is an itchy dermatosis, pruritic papules and plaque. That this may progress to blister and bully, mainly on the trunk, involving the umbilicus. It is an important point to separate this dermatosis from other dermatoses that came later, involving the umbilicus. Treatment with topical or systemic steroid, depending on severity, and tapering, I mean decrease the dose of steroid gradually once blister resolve. Regarding its course or its outcome, may spontaneously resolve, but may flare or recur around time of delivery, or may occur after pregnancy with menstruation or oral contraceptive use. When it occurs, it may take weeks to months after delivery to resolve. Typically, return in future pregnancies. May occur in future pregnancies, and when occur in future pregnancies, it is maybe more severe and earlier in its onset. Is there a risk to the fetus? Yes, there is a risk to the fetus in this dermatosis that include increased risk of prematurity and small for gestational age baby. The baby may have mild transient pemphigoid lesion as the mother, and risk to the fetus correlate with disease severity. The more severe disease, the more risk to the fetus. An interesting fact is this disease may occur with choriocarcinoma. A pregnant woman that develop pemphigoid gestations have increased risk of Graves' disease. As I said, it is a subset of bullous pemphigoid, so we have IgA autoantibodies type IgA1 against bullous pemphigoid antigen 180. So on direct immunofluorescence investigation, we see linear C3 along perilesional basement membrane zone. Pregnant women that have bullous pemphigoid gestations strongly associated with human leukocyte antigen DR3 and human leukocyte antigen DR4. This picture represents the pemphigoid gestations. We see papules and plaque. Some of them progress to bully, which is either intact or rupture, mainly on the trunk, including the umbilicus. The second dermatosis is polymorphic eruption of a pregnancy. Also, its onset in the late pregnancy, third trimester or immediately postpartum period. Its clinical appearance is urticarial, pruritic papule and plaque, which prefer or start in the abdominal striae, sparing the umbilicus. This disease sparing the umbilicus, unlike pemphigoid gestations that involving the umbilicus. Usually spare the face and extremities. This mainly occur on the abdomen and usually on the thigh also. It's a treatment by topical steroid and antihistamine may improve. Regarding its course, resolve over 4 weeks, typically does not recur in subsequent pregnancies. The good news, there is no risk to the fetus. An interesting fact may seen in primary parous women. In the primary parous women, as a result of distension or rapid distension of its abdomen, and also an increase in multiple gestation pregnancies. Multiple gestation, I mean in twin pregnancies, also as a result of rapid or over distension of the abdomen. These pictures all include polymorphic eruption of a pregnancy. You see a distribution of lesion mainly on the abdominal striae, sparing the umbilicus, and there is also lesion on the thigh, also this lesion on abdominal striae sparing the thigh, this lesion also sparing, umbilicus, this lesion also sparing the umbilicus, and these show the primary lesion of polymorphic eruption of a pregnancy that include urticarial papules and the plaque. Another subject is intrahepatic cholestasis of a pregnancy. Its onset also in the third trimester. Its appearance, it is important to know, this dermatosis have no primary skin lesion, usually present with secondary skin lesion as a result of itching. So it is presented with excoriation and prurigo typically seen on extensor surfaces. Prurigo, whether it is prurigo nodularis or prurigo simplex. Extreme generalized pruritus without primary lesion, as I said. Worse at night, but on palm and sole. May associated with jaundice in 10% of patient. Treatment and its course. Must decrease serum bile acid level by giving the patient chelating agent which is called oral ursodeoxycholic acid. Also may recur in future pregnancies and can flare with oral contraceptive pills. The patient may have an additional feature of steatorrhea and vitamin K deficiency, so may lead to postpartum hemorrhage. Pruritus resolves shortly after delivery. The most important treatment is the chelating agent and termination of pregnancy. Is there a risk to the fetus? Yes, there is a risk to the fetus, which is include a premature birth or intrapartum fetal distress and even stillbirth. Risk correlate with the level of bile acid, usually more than 40 micromole per liter. Increased total serum bile acid level occur as a result of decrease its excretion. These pictures shows the secondary lesion of intrahepatic cholestasis of a pregnancy, which is mainly on extensor surface. This picture show excoriation and prurigo simplex, and this picture show a prurigo nodularis and also excoriation. An additional entity which is called atopic eruption of a pregnancy, or what is called a prurigo of a pregnancy. This differ from other subjects that usually occur in early pregnancy, so it is occur in first or second trimester. Its appearance like an atopic dermatitis, present with an eczematous or papular eruption in typical sites. A typical site for atopic dermatitis in adult flectural, so it is occur mainly in flectural surfaces. Typically, in patient with atopic history, it is either a flare of a pre-existing atopic dermatitis and occurring during pregnancy, or mainly it is the first time that the patient have atopic dermatitis, which is usually occur in 80% of patient. Treatment like atopic dermatitis, topical steroid, emollient, antihistamine, sometimes phototherapy by using UVB, which is safe in pregnant women, for symptoms control. Usually may recur in future pregnancy. Is there a risk to the fetus? No, there is no risk to the fetus. There may have an increased IgA level in pregnant women. Also, it is Thia2 mediated. Thia2, it is cell mediated, T helper 2 mediated. And it is the most common pruritic disorder of a pregnancy. You should put in your mind that atopic dermatosis of a pregnancy is the most common dermatosis of a pregnancy. There is no risk to the fetus, came in early pregnancy. These pictures show atopic eruption of a pregnancy, pruritic papules, mainly in the flectural area. Also, this is a pruritic papule in abdomen, mainly accentuated in the flectural area. And this dermatosis should be distinguished from scabies as undifferential diagnosis. Other disorder, which is impetigo herpetiformis, some texts consider this dermatosis is specific for pregnancy, and other considered is as a dermatosis that is occur in every subject, which is the same pustular psoriasis. Pustular psoriasis, but when occur in a pregnancy, called impetigo herpetiformis. Its onset, it is usually in third trimester. Its appearance, it is like or same pustular psoriasis, that is starting in flexure, groin mainly. Treatment as pustular psoriasis in normal population, which is supportive, sometimes use prednisolone. Resolve with delivery, so one of the treatment option is termination of a pregnancy, and may recur with future pregnancies or with oral contraceptive use. There is a risk to the fetus, which is include placental insufficiency and stillbirth and neonatal death in bad disease. And also there is risk to pregnant women, which is hypocalcemia and decreased vitamin D. Also, patient may have cardiac or renal failure. These pictures show impetigo herpetiformis, which is pustular psoriasis but is occurring during pregnancy. These lesions plug, and on the periphery there is multiple pustules. This typical picture, multiple pustules on a plug of psoriasis with erythema, and this is also impetigo herpetiformis accentuated mainly in a flexure. This picture or diagram is so important to know how to deal with a pregnant woman came to you with a pruritus, which is called approach to a pregnant woman with a pruritus. When a pregnant woman came to you with a pruritus, the first question to ask yourself is there is a primary skin lesion? If there is no primary skin lesion, and the patient came in late pregnancy, so you put in your mind intrahepatic cholestasis of a pregnancy. As I said previously, there is no primary skin lesion, only secondary such as excoriation on and prurigo. On examination or investigation, direct immune fluorescence non-specific, H and E stain non-specific. Lab investigation, we see elevated total serum bile acid level. Risk, you should put in mind risk to the fetus, which is a prematurity and fetal distress and stillbirth, and treatment mainly by ursodeoxycholic acid and termination of a pregnancy. If there is a primary skin lesion, ask your patient, is it related to pregnancy? So, came in dermatosis of a pregnancy, which is either in early pregnancy involving mainly a trunk and limb, so put in your mind maybe atopic eruption of a pregnancy, which is, as I said previously, 20% exacerbated pre-existing atopic dermatitis and 80% it is first occurrence. By investigation, direct immune fluorescence non-specific, H and E stain non-specific. Lab investigation may or may not have an increased level of serum IgE, no fetal risk, and the treatment by steroid, antihistamine, and UVB sometimes. If this primary skin lesion occur in late pregnancy, I mean third trimester and postpartum, we should take two diseases in your mind, which is either polymorphic eruption of a pregnancy, which is present with articarial papular eruption, sparing the umbilicus by investigation, direct immune fluorescence non-specific, H and E stain non-specific, lab investigation non-specific, no fetal risk, and the treatment by steroid and antihistamine, or it is pemphigoid gestationis, which is presented with vesicopulous lesion, including the umbilicus. By direct immune fluorescence as bullous pemphigoid, we see linear C3 along dermoepidermal junction. H and E stain, also as bullous pemphigoid, we see eosinophil plus minus subepidermal blister. Lab investigation, other lab, such as positive indirect immune fluorescence. There is a risk to the fetus, which is a small for gestational age and a prematurity. Treatment also by corticosteroid and antihistamine, and sometimes termination of pregnancy. We finish your lecture.